This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Video. Hey folks, Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and welcome to Copycat Friday. That's right, I cut my hair, not because of so many of you wanted me to, but because I just got tired of it myself. It was my own choice.
Your boyfriend made you do it, Jordy.
Shut up, Janik. I have a girlfriend, not a boyfriend. So in this weekly series, we recreate exciting film techniques and visual effects from music videos, films, and amazing creators around the world. Today we're looking at the epic Mirror Dash video from Julien. A very creative video, definitely worth checking out. I'm gonna leave a link to his video in the description. But now, how did they do it? How did Julien run so fast? So many mysteries, but you know what's not a mystery? Our sponsor, Storyblocks Video. It's a complete library for any creative filmmaker, and they have made it super simple for anyone to use. There's only a single price per year, which grants you unlimited downloads going from high quality stock clips, transitions, effects, templates, and so much more. And we also came across these hand-drawn elements, which are gonna be perfect for the video that we're working on today. Now we are going to share some free elements by the end of the video, but if you are planning to create a longer Mirror Dash video like Julien did, then I could definitely recommend checking out these from Storyblocks. For more information, you can click the first link in the description below. And we're back at my place. The video effect itself is not really that hard, but it is very time consuming. All you're gonna need is a smartphone and a bathroom with a mirror. Ideally, you wanna have two cabinets or a towel or something hanging on the outsides of the mirror, as we're going to use that to transition to the next cut every time. Now, very important is gonna be that you can lock the focus and exposure of your phone's camera. Some phones already have such pro features built in. If you can't find it, then try to download an app that can. We used Filmic Pro, which allows us to control the camera completely manual. Now let's start simple. The only thing that you have to do now is take up a pose and run from one end to the other. Then do that again and perhaps take a different pose. Now you could gradually change your poses like me and Janik here were doing during the fight so that it seems like a fluent action. Do try your best to always keep your phone at the same height and walk as steady as possible. You don't need to run fast, just focus on the stability. In Adobe Premiere Pro, simply place your different shots next to each other. Make sure that they transition smooth by letting the cabinet swipe in front of the lens. Next, we're going to add an effect called Warp Stabilizer to all of the shots. This might take some time as Premiere will now analyze and stabilize your shots. When it's done, you want to change the smoothness to around 10%. A minimal stabilization, which is going to make it a little bit smoother. Then finally select everything in your timeline, right-click and choose Nest. And this will group everything together into a new sequence. Right-click then on that nested sequence and choose Speed Duration. Set the speed to around 250%, and that's it. This already is gonna give you the desired effect. However, there are many playful things that we could add to this basic idea. Let's start off with speed. If you want yourself to move faster, what you could do is start by trimming your clips shorter so that the ending and the beginning do not cover the cabinets. If you have a specific part that goes faster within your edit, I would suggest to disable the speed increasement that we've done before and work with time remapping. That works as follows. you first right-click on the FX button of your nested sequence, and then choose Time Remapping Speed. With the pen tool from your toolbox, we can now add points on the line of the nested sequence that represent the speed of the clip. So in the beginning, we drag the point up to around 250%. But as you move faster, we move the second point higher to maybe around 400%. In between, you make sure that we gradually go from one speed to another. In the end, it works the exact same way. You set a point which defines the end of the current speed, then go a little bit further and drag a new point back to around 250%. And that's one trick to create parts where you go faster. You don't actually need to run faster while filming. Now, there are several drawings that you saw in the intro, which are gonna be a great addition to any action in your video. Basically, these can be still pictures. Now, you can find them all over the web or on stock websites. If you like to have a small animation in those drawings, it might be a little trickier to find them online. Storyblocks have a bunch like we've seen before. Anyways, there's no simple trick to get such animations or even pictures. If you want to create them yourself, you're gonna have to draw them inside Photoshop or Illustrator. Now, Janik made a few of these in Illustrator and then exported them to PNG files so that we can use them inside Premiere Pro. From the link in the description, you can download these for free if you like so. Now, one of them are these stripes on the top and the bottom. Now, we've got 5 of these. You could place them on top of your nested sequence for about 2 frames. Then you place a new stripe picture next to it and let it stay for 2 frames as well. Keep doing this for the duration that you want. To blow out these stripes a bit more, you could change their blending mode to Linear Dodge Add, and then decrease the opacity a bit. For even more glow, you could add a white solid in there as well and mask out the middle part. When you're done, invert the mask and increase its feather a bunch. Finally, also change the blending mode to Add and decrease the opacity. And that is gonna give you this result right here. Now, apart from these stripes, you could also add other elements like a punch. And these you can also download and are again a few images that enlarge the punch over time. Just stack them on your clip. Now, finally, one of the last things I like to mention is that you could also do some creative camera movements. For instance, let's go of your smartphone. Of course, your smartphone still needs to move as well, so Janik hold it with a stick underneath the camera frame. Now, this is a brown stick that matched with the colors of the background so that it won't take up too much attention. And on there, I had a phone mount taped to it. Now, honestly, this wasn't so easy. Julien definitely pulled out these shots fantastic. Big props to him. Another fun trick is where you slowly turn your camera around with every shot. Putting them into a sequence gives you a nice rotation. You could also stop mid-frame and do something fun like suddenly going up like we did when Janik punched me. And this goes, of course, exactly the same, but now you just jump up from the mirror every time. And those were the tips to create a mirror dash video yourself. It's definitely a lot of fun, and if you do make one yourself too, then make sure to upload that video to Instagram and tag us in your post. I would love to see it. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks, for the support. And like always, stay creative. So, just as I was about to turn off the lights, open the studio dome and everything, I just realized something. I'm wearing the wrong t-shirt. I'm not gonna do it again, guys. No, as you can hear, my throat, it's a big mess. I'm actually a little bit sick right now.